Dear Patricia, dear Scott, it's a pleasure to have you here. The American Swiss Foundation is dedicated to strengthening the historic friendship and promoting close economic ties between the United States and Switzerland, particularly through its Young Leaders Conference, which strives to create person-to-person exchange and foster mutual understanding among future leaders of Switzerland and the United States. Could you tell me more about the American Swiss Foundation?
Thank you, Mr. Ambassador. Thank you, Marcus. It's great to be here with you and share a few thoughts about the American Swiss Foundation's work. Indeed, it is 75 years old. It was founded on May 1st of 1945 by a group of American businessmen who were concerned that Switzerland's reputation in the United States had suffered during World War II, and that there was a need for a private citizen-to-citizen dialogue between Americans and Swiss to clarify issues between Switzerland and the United States. And over time, the organization evolved into a more mature organization that cultivated the dialogue between the two countries through business luncheons and in sort of social settings. And in 1990, a new chairman appeared, Ambassador Faith Whittlesey, and she had a fantastic idea to start a program called a Young Leaders Conference to bring together the future leaders of the two countries so they could cultivate a dialogue and connect and exchange about important issues facing the two countries. Now, as you know, Switzerland and the United States are great friends. They are called the sister republics. They share values like individual liberty and the rule of law and free enterprise that make them very, very good friends. But even among friends, you have to cultivate and foster the dialogue so that there isn't any misunderstanding about the role of one or the other.
So from the perspective of the foundation, do you expect a different attitude and different economic priorities by the new administration in Washington regarding Switzerland and compared with the old one?
The U.S.-Swiss relationship is one that is very deep and very important. And I think regardless of the politics, the fact that Switzerland is the sixth largest direct investor in the United States speaks for itself. There are 500,000 Americans who have a job because of Swiss companies investing in the U.S. These are very well-paying jobs. They're among the highest paid of any foreign direct investors. They're in jobs in research, in development. So I think, again, regardless of the politics of the day, the relationship is very strong and important to both countries. Switzerland had a very good relationship with the United States and with the Trump administration. There was a great deal of interest in Switzerland because of the strong business relationship. High-level visits took place. The Swiss president visited the American president in the White House for the first time in history. So that was very, very special. Dr. Biden, the first lady, visited Switzerland many years ago and has a great understanding of the Swiss apprenticeship system. That is of great importance in the U.S.-Swiss relationship. So I think there might be a shift in priorities, in topics of shared interest. But overall, the relationship is extremely strong, and Switzerland is an extremely important partner.
I think the key is who the next ambassador is. Is it someone who's, and what are they focused on? Are they focused on business? So I guess I think that what is a bit unfortunate is that, you know, so the statistics that Patricia just mentioned about Switzerland's economic clout in the United States, and obviously, As everyone should know, it's diplomatic clout, because representing the U.S. kind of in a whole variety of seriously, you know, important issues internationally for the U.S. It's important that someone come in who understands all of these things and can foster them. And if they're just ignored, or if there's a narrow kind of a ideological approach, that's probably not gonna be ideal for the relationship. So.
Thank you very much for your very interesting answers. I'd like to conclude our session with a more personal question. And how is Switzerland perceived by the general American public?
The countries are similar, but they're also very different. Switzerland is small, located in the center of Europe. It had to succeed through its brain power. It has no natural resources. It has a small amount of space that's not covered by mountains. And I think that made the Swiss very, very good at organizing themselves so that they could compete in the world through their brain power and innovation and entrepreneurship. And I think those are things that are very Swiss. Americans are also very entrepreneurial, but in a completely different way. It's an enormous country. Everyone comes from somewhere else. It has an enormous amount of space and natural resources. So a very different feeling, but it's also number one or two in the innovation indexes of the world. And so I think both are very innovative and entrepreneurial. One is small and goes very deep. The other one is large and goes very broad. And so both do really, really well with what they have. And I think deep down, they understand each other because they cherish and value independence and individual liberty. Those are two traits that the Swiss share with the Americans that the European Union member countries may share less. And I think that gives a special bond to the freedom fighters of Switzerland, who inspired the freedom fighters in the United States, who inspired the founding fathers to write their constitution the way they did, and who then took the constitution as an example of how they would write their constitution in 1848. So I think there are shared values of independence, individual liberty, the rule of law that create a close bond between the citizens of the two countries. Much as we are aware that the US is 40 times bigger than Switzerland. So they are different, but they have similar values.
There is a very deep connection, very deep, which, you know, goes back into cultural norms, which are very similar, really, historically. And, you know, it's naturally a very close affinity in our cultural histories that is fundamental and goes, you know, far beyond just sort of superficial politics, I think. So there's room there's always room for that relationship to expand. But it would be tough to stamp out. It's fundamental.
Well, dear Patricia, dear Scott, thank you very much for having taken the time for this very interesting and very exciting chat. Even though I thought I already knew a lot, you know, about the foundation and the ties between the US and Switzerland, I've learned so much more, you know, during our chat. Thank you very much. And I think now we have been looking back to 75 years, you know, of the foundation. And now, you know, at our next contact, we look forward to the next, I'd say, 100 years, you know, of the foundation and the excellent economic and political and cultural ties between Switzerland and the United States. Thank you very much to both of you, Patricia and Scott.